So now we study about the thyroid gland. In thyroid gland, it is the largest endocrine gland which is located over trachea. Before starting from book, we have notes, so we have study from there. Thyroid gland is a butterfly shaped gland. It is the largest endocrine gland located over trachea. This is isthmus. Here is the forelobe of thyroid gland. There are two types of cells, which is parafollicular cells and follicular cells. The follicular cells secretes T3 and T4. T3 is triiodothyronine and T4 is tetraiodothyronine, which is also called as thyroxine. The parafollicular cells release thyrocalcitonin, TCT. For the formation of thyroid hormones like T3 and T4, iodine is play important role. The function of T3 and T4 is regulate BMR, vessel metabolic rate. It produces heat, which is required to maintain the temperature, physical and mental growth, and for normal menstrual cycle. T3 and T4 are amine hormones. If there is a hyposecretion of T3 and T4 in children, it can cause cretinism. Which can cause deaf mutism, low IQ, mental and physical retardation, and thick tongues in children. If there is a hypothyroidism in adult, it can cause myxedema, which cause low BMR, gain of weight, and failure to conceive. Simple goiter is a nutritional deficiency of iodine, in which there is an enlargement of thyroid gland. It is mainly in hilly areas. If there is a hypersecretion of thyroid hormone, it is known as hyperthyroidism, which is corrected by using antithyroid hormone drugs. It increases because of higher secretion of thyroid hormone. It can cause increase in BMR. Due to increase in BMR, the person become lean and thin in physique. Heat intolerance due to production of calorigenic process. Now we are discussing about how the hyperthyroidism will occur. It is occurred due to the thyroid tumor. Did you know about the Graves' disease? Graves' disease is an autoimmune disease in which antibodies are formed which mimic like thyroid stimulating hormone, in which there is a disease exophthalmic goiter in which the eyeball is protruded out. Here it is written that the thyroid gland is composed of two lobes which are located on the either side of the trachea. Both the lobes are connected with a thin flap of connective tissue called isthmus. The thyroid gland is composed of follicles and stromal tissues. His thyroid follicle is composed of follicular cells enclosing a cavity. These follicular cells synthesize two hormones, tetraiodothyronine or thyroxine T4 and triiodothyronine T3, as I told you. Iodine is essential for the normal rate of hormone synthesis in the thyroid. Deficiency of iodine in our diet results in hypothyroidism, an enlargement of the thyroid gland, commonly called goiter. Hypothyroidism during pregnancy causes defective development and maturation of growing baby, leading to stunted growth. Cretinism, as I told you, that the hyposecretion of thyroid hormone in children causes cretinism and in adults it causes myxedema. Here it is written that in adults, hypothyroidism may cause menstrual cycle to become irregular. Due to cancer of thyroid gland or due to development of nodules of thyroid gland, the rate of synthesis and secretion of the thyroid hormone is increased to abnormal high level, leading to the condition called hyperthyroidism. Simply, in hyperthyroidism, there is tumor in the thyroid gland. Exophthalmic goiter is a form of hyperthyroidism characterized by the enlargement of the thyroid gland and protrusion of the eyeball, means the eyeball will protrude out, means eyeball is just like a tumor. Thyroid hormone play an important role in the regulation of the BMR. These hormones also support the process of red blood cell formation. Thyroid hormone control the metabolism of carbohydrate, protein and fat because it will regulate the BMR. Maintenance of water and electrolyte balance is also influenced by thyroid hormone. Thyroid gland also secrete a protein hormone called thyrocalcitonin, which is releasing from the parafollicular cells, which I told you in the starting, which regulate the blood calcium level. So now we are discussing these from starting. We learn that the thyroid gland is the largest endocrine gland. It is located over trachea. It is butterfly shaped. There are two types of cells, follicles, follicular cells and parafollicular cells. The follicular cells release T3 and T4 and the parafollicular cells release thyrocalcitonin. T3 is triiodothyronine and T4 is tetraiodothyronine, which is also known as thyroxine. Formation of thyroid hormone is by iodination, in which iodine is mainly play important role. The hypothalamus released thyroid releasing hormone, which acting on the pituitary and releasing thyroid stimulating hormone, which acting on the thyroid to release T3 and T4. The function of T3 and T4 is regulate BMR. It stimulate production of heat, physical and mental growth, and for normal menstrual cycle. And if there is a hyposecretion of T3 and T4, it can cause cretinism in children, myxedema in adult. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is an autoimmune disease. Simple goiter is a nutritional deficiency of iodine, which causes enlargement of the thyroid gland. Hyperthyroidism. In hyperthyroidism, BMR increase, lean and thin physique of the patient, heat intolerance. Graves' disease is an autoimmune disease in which there is the antibodies mimic the TSH. Then exophthalmic goiter is in which the eyeball will protrude out. Thiourea break down thyroxine. If a tadpole take thiourea, then he never convert to frog. Hyperthyroidism can also result due to thyroid tumor. Then thyrocalcitonin, which is releasing from the parafollicular cells, which is peptide hormone having 32 amino acids secreted by parafollicular cells, secreted in response to high blood calcium level. It means they decrease the blood calcium level. If it is decreasing the blood calcium level, it means it inhibit osteoclast and increase osteoblast. Osteoclast is reabsorption of calcium from bones, and osteoblast is deposition of calcium into the bones. So it inhibit osteoclast क्योंकि ये जो है bone से calcium को निकलवाना कम करता है और bones में calcium का decomposition बढ़ाता है क्योंकि इसको blood में calcium के level को कम करना है और इसलिए ये absorption in the gut of calcium ion भी decrease करता है. Inhibit increase in excretion of calcium ion because इसको जो है blood से calcium level कम करना है तो ये excrete कराता है calcium ion को. Now the parathyroid gland is hypercalcemic, is releasing hypercalcemic hormone. This is the shape of parathyroid gland located on posterior surface of the thyroid gland. Secreted parathormone PTH, it is also known as Calypso hormone, antagonist of TCT thyrocalcitonin, increase the level of blood calcium.
अगर ये ब्लड का कैल्शियम लेवल बढ़ा रहा है तो कैसे बढ़ाएगा, बोन से कैल्शियम को निकाल के, तो उसको कहते हैं ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट। तो इट इंक्रीज ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट एक्टिविटी, इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ ब्लड कैल्शियम आयन बाय इंक्रीजिंग ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट एक्टिविटी। ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट इज रीअब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ कैल्शियम फ्रॉम बोन्स, इंक्रीज कैल्शियम रीअब्जॉर्प्शन फ्रॉम किडनी एंड अब्जॉर्प्शन फ्रॉम गट, बिकॉज इट्स इंक्रीज ब्लड कैल्शियम लेवल, सो इट इंक्रीज द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ कैल्शियम फ्रॉम एवरी पार्ट। विटामिन डी इज कन्वर्टेड टू विटामिन D3 बिकॉज विटामिन D3 इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द कैल्शियम एब्जॉर्प्शन। इफ हाइपोसिक्रेशन ऑफ PTH देन हाइपोकैल्सीमिया, बिकॉज देर इज अ लो ब्लड कैल्शियम लेवल विच कॉज टेटनी एंड इंक्रीज इन सोडियम एंड पोटेशियम। क्रैम्स विल अकर, हाइपरसिक्रेशन ऑफ पैराथायराइड हार्मोन, इट कॉज ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस, बोन बिकम फ्रेगाइल एंड इजली फ्रैक्चर्ड ड्यू टू डिफिशेंसी ऑफ कैल्शियम आयन। देन ऑस्टियाइटिस फाइब्रोसा सिस्टिका, दिस इज अ टर्म इन विच बोनी मैट्रिक्स इज रिप्लेस्ड बाई फाइबर्स। फ्रॉम नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग फ्रॉम बुक। Here it is written that in humans, four parathyroid glands are present on the back side of the thyroid gland, one pair each in the two lobes of the thyroid gland. The parathyroid hormone secretes a peptide hormone called parathyroid hormone PTH. The secretion of the PTH is regulated by circulating level of calcium ion. Parathyroid hormone increases the calcium ion in blood. PTH acts on the bone and stimulates the process of bone resorption, dissolution, demineralization. PTH also stimulates reabsorption of calcium by the renal tubules and increase calcium absorption from the digestive food, means it increases the absorption of calcium ion from every part. It is thus clear that PTH is a hypercalcemic hormone, means it increases the blood calcium level, that is it increases the blood calcium level along with TCT. It plays a significant role. TCT is releasing from parafollicular cells. It plays a significant role in calcium balance in the body. Simple. This is all about the thyroid gland and parathyroid gland. In next class, we are discussing about the thymus and adrenal gland. Thank you.